Mister. There will never be a Little Walter. Never.
Walter was one of the best blues harmonica players and harmonica player in the world. But there are great harmonica players that could be greater, but not in his class.
There's no doubt about it. In my opinion, that's an understatement to ask me, do I think he was the greatest? No, I don't think he was the greatest. I know he was the greatest.
Yeah. I said, Walter did more push the harmonica foot than any human being on this earth. On kind of what he did with the harp. He's an amazing cat, man.
Father told me that Walter, when his mother was carrying him, she was out of wedlock, and that they wouldn't permit her to have the baby and have him in the house. So he was born under a tree.
My uncle raised him, Samuel Jacob. Well, my father is uncle, we'll put it that way, and he raised him. And my father went to prison. When he got out of prison, and 1942, he went and he looked up his son. And him and my mother was no longer together. And he was 11 years old. And he called me and said, hey, he said, hey, Tony, that's what he called me. And I said, told my mother, I said, oh, that'll sound like Dad. And I went out there, he said, tell your mother to come outside, I got something to give her. So I said, Mom, I said, Dad said if it'll come to the door, he has something to give. And when I looked at him, and looked at my father, I said, oh, that must be my brother. And sure enough, it was. And that's the last I heard from my brother up until about 1950.
Well, I remember Walter when I first remember him was in Jewtown at my cousin's. He lived there with my cousin. Until he roomed there, him and his girlfriend. I forgot her name, was this kind of skinny, dark-skinned girl. And she was very much in love with him. She bought him his first amplifier. And I think she bought him a chromatic harp, too. Well, he was playing on the street in those days, National Street. Mm-hmm. Played with Moody Jones. He played him and John Henry and another different blues guys. Well, Walter sounded like Sonny Boy Williams. That's the way he played then, in those days.
It was like Muddy and Walter was still playing together. And it was at the Zanzibar one night, and this lady, she was paying to hear Juke. And she gave Muddy $2. Jimmy Rogers, she gave him $1. She had 50 cents left. So she gave that to Walter. And Walter got mad about that. And Walter, floor.
Down in Alabama, anywhere else, you could walk in the pawn shop and buy a harmonica for 50 cents. And after little Walter put out that record, Juke, they went up to $510. Because the maker, I think, found out what a harmonica could be used for, and Walter proved it.
This is like a Every baby you see born in the world has a mother. You see? And that was the mother of his style, the beginning of his style. You see?
Yeah, he could do as much with a harmonica as a horn player could with a horn. And Walter could even play jazz. For example, like B.B. King was carrying a whole Greyhound busload of musicians, right? And here come Walter with three musicians up there and drew all the crowd.
Yeah. He was popular. He was hot. He had plenty of gigs, 3 months at a time. We'd be gone for months. Months at a time. Everywhere, Florida, Alabama, Louisiana.
Walter was doing so many one-nighters. Was pathetic, and it was fulfilling them too, you know what I mean? And he used to drive 120 miles an hour trying to get to a gig.
When they get paid, they be drunk when they get their money. When they leave the job, they just out cold. What I mean, out cold, him and Tucker both be knocked out. Or when they're paying the other camera, he be just getting pictures. They be laying up, the money laying all over the floors and the suitcase full of money. I mean, suitcases of money. Yeah, he made nice money.
I'm just a fool, can't help myself. I love you, baby, and no one else. I ain't crazy, you are my baby. I'm just a fool.
And he was a great lover, too. He was women, so, oh, man, he knew how to make them moan and groan. And one time I said, I told Tuck, you can be in the hall and you can hear him in the room just moaning. I mean, he could make a moan. And I wanted to know what he was doing. So I told Tuck, I said, I'm peeping this keyhole right here tonight. When he do that again, I want to see what the heck is he doing. And you know, Tucker went and told him. And then when the girl started moaning, I went to the keyhole was covered up.
And I asked him when he was there the last time, I said, you have any children? He said, no, I don't want no children. I said, you have a wife? He said, what any use in buying somebody you can get the milk free?
You're so fine. Want to love you all the time. You're so fine, pretty baby. Let me love you all the time.
He was living fast. You see, he always was going too fast. And he tried to make me go fast with him.
I don't know why he started going down like that. Because as far as the harmonica playing, he still had it. There's no doubt about that.
Ain't no need of going no further, brother. Ain't no need of going no further, man. Told you back in 45, you had better quit that job. Ain't no need of going no further, man.
Having lots of problems, like doing things that was not so, you know, silly things. And or drinking and maybe a little drugging, something like that. And he was going down, and when he was singing the song, "I don't need to go on no further," Odie Payne, we would look at each other and we knew that's just what he was singing about himself. "And I don't need to go on no further, brother."
I know one thing. And it is that when you fly so high, which you can also do one thing.
It was about 12 something. And about 10 minutes after that, the phone rang. And she said, she said, "Brother Walter's dead." I said, "How you know?" She said, "Muddy called me."
She said, "Turn the radio on W, whatever it was." And I turned the radio and I heard this little Walter music. And I said, "That's little Walter. I know who it is." She said, "Walter dead."
I said, "You gotta be kidding." She said, "No." I said, "Come on." She said, "No." But I couldn't believe it. Because me and him used to always bullshit about a thing that said, I said, motherfucker.
You gonna die. I said, you gonna die too, motherfucker. But I ain't gonna die. So I'm gonna get so motherfucking old, I turn to a gray mule before I leave here. He said, well, fuck that shit. Said, elephant live longer than a damn mule. That's what Walter said. And I'll be here then. You know what I mean?